Hey guys, Mudslinger Tool back at you. Today what we're looking at is we're gonna refill these 1 pound propane tanks. You buy these in the store, like $3 a piece or something like that. They come with 1 pound of propane in them, or you can buy a 20 gallon tank for like your grill, and it's usually about 17, 18 bucks. But basically, if you were to take this and multiply it by the 20 pound tank, that's about a $60 tank. So I'm gonna show you how to get the most use out of this and refill them. All right, first what we need, you got this little adapter here. This part plugs into your 20 pound cylinder, and then that part there accepts your 1 pound cylinder. There's a special way you gotta do it, so I'll let you know. We got the little adapter attached. Propane tanks always gotta be upside down. We'll screw this in. And then turn on our propane tank. You can hear it hissing. What most people think is that with that little adapter, by the way, I'll put that link. Well, I'll put the name of the adapter in the body here, and you can go online and search it. It's about 15, 20 bucks, but it's brass, pretty much never goes back bad. So this is done hissing. And that's what most people think a full cylinder is. And that's what they sell you as a full cylinder. However, if we put this on a scale here, we're looking at 1.27 pounds. Now that's basically what you would get that tank at from the store. Is about 1.5 pounds. That's including the propane. So this is what they don't tell you. You're gonna need a pair of curved hemos, a little small pair of curved hemos. You can get them online, $1.50, $2, $3. But there's this little valve here. See that little tit inside of it? If you clamp onto that, and you pull, which I can't seem to do, it exhausts gas. Well, there's really not enough in there. I can hear it, but so what we want to do is we want to screw this on the tank with this valve on the top, because it will only accept gas. Well, propane's not a gas. Propane's a liquid. It becomes a gas when it hits air. So we want to screw it on the tank to where if you have to back it up or tighten it a little bit, it don't matter. But you want to put it where the valve is on the top. And then we're going to open this again. I'm gonna reach in here with our hemos. So you're gonna pull that valve. You just click your hemos on it and kind of bend them backwards to hear the gas escaping. Let a little gas escape, then let it fill up. Let a little gas escape, let it fill up. basically what we're looking for is we're looking for the actual liquid propane to start coming out of the top of this valve. Let some air out, give it a minute. I got the radio on, but without the radio on, you can hear it kind of hissing, filling up the tank. When it stops hissing, give it another squeeze, let a little bit of the air out. You can fit 2 pounds of liquid propane in this 1 pound tank. They have to put 1 pound on there because they're only giving you 1 pound of propane. But the tank will hold 2 pounds of propane. If it was pressurized, you wouldn't be able to hold 2 pounds of propane because of the fact that there's not enough room in the tank. But since it's not gas, it's liquid, they do that for transporting purposes, because they can't have them totally full. All right, so I'm gonna move you closer here. Now, when we pull this, you can actually see the liquid propane. I don't know if you can, but you can actually see the liquid propane falling out of the tank from that valve. So now we're gonna go shut the tank off. Now we got a full tank. So here we go, we got 2.6 pounds. Instead of 1 pound, we got 2 pounds of liquid in that same tank. It'll last you twice as long, and you filled it up for half as much. All right, guys, that's all I got for you today. Hit me with a like. Smash the subscribe button as I learn it. I'll pass it on to you. Have a good one, be safe.